Father, we thank you for another opportunity to hear your word. Mighty God, we pray that you will speak to us. We pray that you will open our hearts to receive from you. We pray that your word will be simple enough for us to understand. We pray, Lord, that your word will ignite a new level of faith in us. Oh Lord, we pray that your word will bless us and your name will be glorified. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. So today we're moving forward, we're looking at a topic, make room for the new. Make room for the new. If it's a new season, then you also have to, you know, make room for it so that it doesn't catch you unprepared. And I'm taking my text from Leviticus chapter 26, verse 10. Leviticus chapter 26, verse 10. It says, you will still be eating last year's harvest when you will have to move it out to make room for the new. And that's where I extracted the title, the last part of that line. You will still be eating last year's harvest when you have to make room, when you have to move it out to make room for the new. And I believe in my mind, in my spirit, that somebody has been eating last year's harvest, which was good. It was good when it came, but God is saying it's the time to be prepared for a new harvest. And that harvest is coming your way in Jesus' name. Oh, when you got that job last year, it was the biggest miracle of the year for you. But God is bringing a better one this season. In the mighty name of Jesus. When the news of that promotion came to you, it was so delightful to your soul, and you are still dwelling on that. I have the word of God for you. God is taking you to a new level. He's taking you to a new level. In the mighty name of Jesus, when your income increased in the past few months, you were so delightful with that. But God is saying that was not enough. Make ready your barns because increase is coming. In the mighty name of Jesus, if you believe that, shout a believing hallelujah. Make room for the new. Isaiah chapter 3 verses 18 to 19 tell us, do not remember the former things, nor consider the things of old. For verse 19, behold, I will do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Shall you not know it? I will make gold in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. So the Lord is doing a new thing, and that new thing will manifest in your life and in my life in the name of Jesus. So when we talk about making room for the new, what does it mean? It simply means that you clear out space for something new to come in. It's asking you to clear out space for something new to fit in. And I pray as you clear out the space for something new to come in, that newness will come speedily in the mighty name of Jesus. But one principle governs this fact. One principle, very important, it is that for those who choose to keep dwelling on the past, they cannot embrace the new. That is the principle that governs newness. For those who prefer to keep holding on to the past, they are preventing the arrival of the new. That is what Isaiah chapter 53 verse 18 tells us. Do not remember the things of past. Don't consider the things of old. Why? Because God is determined to do a new thing. So the success of yesterday may be good, it may be fantastic, but God is telling you at this time, that was good. Prepare for something new. And as you prepare for something new, the Lord will surprise you. The Lord will surprise me. If you don't believe that, the Lord will surprise me. I thought you said to yourself, the Lord will surprise me.
Amen.
I hope people are in the church this morning. The Lord will surprise me.
The Lord.
Pleasantly, in the mighty name of Jesus. I want to tell you something. You cannot afford to be embracing the past successes as good as they were. You have to come to a point of determination when you want to embrace what is new. Why? Because where God is taking you is more important to where God has taken you. Are you with me? What God wants to do in your life, in this season, in your family, in this season, in your finances, in this season, is far more than what He has done in the past. Why am I saying this? The greater works of God in your life is not in yesterday of your life. It's in your tomorrow. It's in your tomorrow. And so God will do a new thing.
Amen.
It will spring forth. In the mighty name of Jesus, you just have to align your faith with me and determine in your heart, in your mind, to, you know, make room for that new. And how do you make room for the new? You have to prepare for it. And when you are making room for something, you are not just making room in your mind, you are practically making preparation. That is what is required of you. For you to make room, you have to literally prepare. Leviticus 26 verse 10 says that you have to move it out to make room for the new. If you are moving it out, you are making preparation. And what are the things that you need to prepare for? Or how do you engage in your preparation? You need to prepare your mind. Number one thing to prepare is your mind. Very important, and as a matter of fact, it is basic. Because when the new is coming with transformation, and every transformation requires a renewal of the mind. Romans chapter 12, verse 2. We know that by now. So the first preparation is the preparation of your mind. And how do you prepare your mind? Keep your mind open to God's method, to God's way, not your predefined methodology, not the way you assume it should work. You cannot be boxing God in your assumption. You cannot be boxing God into your own way that you expect it to happen. Remember when Naaman came to Elisha, and Elisha sent a word to him. He said he was expecting the man of God, you know, to do some drama and then for the miracle to happen, but he did not do the drama. And yet, with simple obedience, he got his miracle. So, you are preparing your mind by opening up your mind to God's way, and God's way can be anyhow. The Lord will visit you this season in a way that only He wants to do, in the mighty name of Jesus. So when God is telling you that He will make a road in the wilderness, do not begin to calculate how many headcount He needs to execute that project. Are you with me? When God tells you that He's going to provide water for you in the desert, don't begin to estimate how many pipelines it needs to run to channel the water. That is for God to figure out. Open your mind up to God for Him to do it in His own way. Acts chapter 10, verses 9 to 16. The Bible tells us about the story of Peter. God, you know, with the Spirit of God, he got caught up into trance and he saw four-footed animals going up and down, and God told him in that vision, take and eat. What did Peter say? Peter said, oh, I have never eaten anything that is unclean. 3 times, God repeated it, and Peter declined, and the Bible said that, and the vision went to heaven. God was trying to move Peter into a new dimension of ministerial breakthrough to reach the Gentiles. And Peter was, refusing to cooperate with God in his own way, in his own style. He preferred to hold on to the tradition of the Pharisee. And he almost missed out on God. May you not miss out on God this season. In the mighty name of Jesus. You know, new season brings new system. And that was what God was trying to introduce to Peter in that Acts chapter 10, 9 to 16. And Peter was holding on to the old system. So you have to work on your mind. You have to make your mind open. You have to be also sensitive. The scripture tells us in Luke chapter 5, 37, says, no man puts a new wine into the old wine skin. So if you are seeing something new, your mind must also be renewed. Otherwise, the scripture says that the wine skin will get busted and the wine will be wasted. So it's very important for you to prepare your mind. Make it open to God. Make it ready to receive in any dimension that God wants to give. In any direction that God wants to lead. Keep your mind open. Keep your options open. Keep it sensitive. Somebody that was not nice to you last month could be the vessel that God has proposed to use to bring that miracle this season. So you cannot afford to engage in prejudice and assume it was bad last month, was bad last year, it will remain to be bad this season. Be sensitive to how God must do these things. That is the way to get ready. That is the way to get prepared. You also need to be prepared in your prayer. To get prepared in your prayer. And this is very important. You will be the joker of the century when you receive a life-changing prophecy and then you go and relax and you begin to sleep in tribulation waiting for a day of manifestation. I want to tell you, it does not work that way. Prayer helps you to enforce the prophetic to ensure that it comes to pass. Did you hear that? Prayer helps you to enforce the prophetic, to bring it into manifestation. To bring it into manifestation. Otherwise, that is the difference between people who receive the prophetic and they see the manifestation, and the people who receive it and nothing happens. It is not because the same word does not have impact, but it is the way to treat and take the word that matters. And how do you show your preparation in this season of new season is that you engage in prayer like never before. Like never before. Daniel tells us, Daniel chapter 9 verse 2, he said, I understood by the scripture the word of the Lord according to prophet Jeremiah, that the desolation of Jerusalem will last for 70 years. And so 70 years came, nothing happened. What did Daniel do? He did not read that scripture and went into tribulation and was expecting. He switched into a prolonged prayer mood. Daniel 9:3, he says, I stood for the Lord and pleaded with him in prayer and petition with fasting. He did that for 3 weeks, 21 days. So when we receive the prophetic, it is not a time to celebrate, it's a time to engage in prayers like Daniel did. in verse 2, 39, he said he discovered in the scripture, he was referencing Jeremiah 25 verse 11. He said he read in the scripture what God wrote concerning Jerusalem. And that has not come to pass. Even though 70 years has come, they were still in captivity. Daniel switched into prayer mode. And as he went into prayer, God sent an angel to ensure that that prophecy received manifestation. I pray you will not be weak in the place of prayer. You will not be weak in the place of prayer. In the mighty name of Jesus, as you receive the word of God this season, as you study the scripture and you see the promises of God, as you embrace them in prayer, in fasting, the Lord will show up for you. In the mighty name of Jesus, look at Jacob. Jacob has received the blessings of his father. Genesis 27, 28 to 29. And he was already manifesting those blessings. He got to the house of labor. He prospered. Everything he touched, prosperity followed. But he realized there's always a new dimension. There's always a new thing that comes out of the hole. He still engaged the angel of God in prayer. Genesis 32, 22 for 32. He wrestled with the angel of God. And do you know what happened to him with that encounter? He got a new name. His name got changed from Jacob to Israel. And that name was very pivotal to his destiny. So he did not just dwell on the level of blessing. He moved further to make room for the new by engaging the angel of God. In prayer, in warfare, and the Bible said he prevailed. He got a new name. That is how to get ready for the new. It is in the place of prayer. Even as you have renewed your mind, as you have made your mind open, you prepared your mind, you also prepare in prayer. What happens in the place of prayer is that you develop capacity to receive the new. You develop that capacity. That was what happened to Jacob. In the place of prayer, he prevailed and he had a new name. I pray the Lord visit you. As you engage in prayer this season, the Lord visit you.
Amen.
For a lifetime encounter in the mighty name of Jesus. Also need to prepare in patience, and I like this. This is very important. You prepare with your mind, to get your mind ready. You prepare in prayer. You prepare also in patience, and that's very important. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 36, very clear. He said, "You have the need of patience when you have done the will of God, that you may receive the promise." You have the need of patience when you have done the will of God, that you may receive the promise. Patience is very important. Why is patience important? Because God's timeline is not your timeline. God does not work within the same scope of calendar that we work with. It does not work with this same scope of 24 hours making a day that you and I are familiar with. He has his own timing program only for him. And the Bible says that he makes all this beautiful in his own time. And what does that tell you? Even though God may be bringing you into a new season, there is an appointed time for that season to manifest. And that time will be now.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus. Remember Ecclesiastes chapter 3 verse 1. It tells us, to everything there is a season and a time for every purpose under heaven. So there is a difference between a season and a time. I said this last week. Romans chapter 8, 25. He said, but if we wait for what we do not yet have, we wait for it patiently. So patience is important. Even as you are trusting God to bring you into a new season. And let me simplify this for somebody who is still not sure. You know when God met with Moses, Exodus chapter 3. When God met with him, God told him, he said, I have seen the affliction of my people, Israel, and I am determined to deliver them from the hand of their taskmaster and bringing them into a land that is good and large, a land flowing with milk and honey. So that statement from God in Exodus chapter 3 has shifted the season for Israelites. But in between the statement, a lot of things happened. Moses went back to Egypt as the Lord commanded, and Pharaoh increased the affliction of the people. God sent plagues to the land to increase the confusion and the tension. But God constantly reassured them of his promise through signs and wonders. So God spoke to Moses in Exodus chapter 3 that he has seen the affliction is bringing them out into the promised land. But they did not march out of Egypt until Exodus chapter 12. Are you with me? That was the appointed time for the season that God brought them into to manifest. Does it make sense now? The moment Anna prayed in Shiloh and had an encounter with Eli the prophet, a season has been changed, but the appointed time came when Samuel showed up. And the appointed time comes quickly. Why am I spending time on this? So that you don't get confused. That, oh, pastor preached that we are in the new season, but things are still looking up. The fact that you have not seen it does not mean that God has not started it. He said, behold, I will do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. So God may have started doing it before he springs up for you to see. It does not mean that God has not started, even though you may not have seen it. That is the point. So you only just need to understand that there is a time for every purpose under the earth. Even though for everything that is season, but there is an appointed time for the manifestation. I pray for you, your appointed time will not be delayed. Your appointed time will not be delayed. As you are waiting on God to see that new season, that time will turn in your favor. The time will turn in your favor. In the mighty name of Jesus. Joseph was still in the prison. Helpless. Last word to the chief butler was that when you get restored into your position, don't forget me. That was his last word. And that was a word of somebody who was like, hey, I was in need of a desperate help. And for 2 full years, the guy forgot him. And Joseph, like you and me, may have maybe given it to God. But God was working, even though Joseph did not know. God has created a national problem in the dream of Pharaoh that nobody could give interpretation. At that point in time, the season of Joseph has started. But the appointed time came when Pharaoh sent for him. And the Bible says that when the word of God came to him, he could not be held back. I pray for the appointed time you will not be held back. At your appointed time you will not be held back. In the mighty name of Jesus. But you need patience. Very important. Because you cannot confuse this new season with the appointment. shifting in your favor. God, we are approaching to that season, but you are yet to see it. Things are still not looking good. It does not mean that God has not started it. Things are still not going easy. It does not mean that God has not fixed it. You are only waiting for the appointed time to come, and your time will come speedily in the name of Jesus. So in your preparation, in patience, you need to grow. You know that everything that grows up stays up, but everything that jumps up, they come down. Okay? And that's the key for somebody. Everything that jump up, they must come down. But everything that grow up, they stay up. Your patience will help you to grow up and be ready to receive from God. May God help you to grow up.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. So as you consciously make this preparation, by preparing your mind, making your mind open to God's option, not your own assumption, as you devote time, you know, to prepare also in prayer, as you make up your mind to be patient with God for His appointed time, what you are doing is that you are growing up so that you can be well fitted into that blessings of God. And the Lord will stabilize you.
Amen.
As you pursue growth in waiting, in planning, in preparing yourself in the name of Jesus. The Lord will stabilize you in the name of Jesus. So you don't want to be the reason for the delay in the appointed time of God. Because God, you know, the love of God for you and me is so much that He doesn't want to give you blessing that will send you to hell. Are you getting my point? He doesn't want to give us blessing that will cut short our lifespan. He wants us to be fully mature. He wants us to come to the place of growth, place of maturity, before that blessing comes, so that when it comes, we can embrace and enjoy it and celebrate His goodness. And I pray for you, the Lord will help you to grow and be ready for His appointed time. In the mighty name of Jesus. Right to your feet, let us pray. Pray. I'm convinced it's a new season for you. But I'm going to pray that God will speed up your appointed time. Cry to God and pray and say, Father, let my appointed time come. Speedily, let my appointed time come. Let my appointed time come with speed.
This is the Liberty Assembly, raising a glorious generation.